remain a young man. So many nonsense. This is not the duty of the spiritual master. However, you may try to keep your body fit. How long you shall keep your body fit? As soon as you are born, the death is also born along with you. And suppose one man is 25 years old, that means he has already died 25 years. So you cannot protect yourself from death. However, you may become very strong, stout. Therefore, actual education, actual spiritual knowledge begins as in the stated in the Bhagavad Gita. The Bhagavad Gita, the beginning of Bhagavad Gita is that when Arjuna surrendered to Krishna, he immediately said that, "My dear Arjuna, you are posing yourself as very learned man, but you are fool number one. Why? Not because you are identifying yourself with this body. Asachyananasuchastang prajñāvādāng suhāsas." My dear Arjuna, you are talking just like very learned man, but you are lamenting on the subject matter of your body. Gatāsuna gatāsuncha nānu sochanti pandita. Actually, one who is learned, he has no necessity for lamenting on the subject, on the body, either living or dead. So the whole process of education in the materialistic way of civilization is on the body. How to keep the body fit, how to avoid death, how to avoid disease, simply concentration on the body. So this bodily concept of life is immediately discouraged in the Bhagavad Gita. Asachyananasuchastang prajñāvādāng suhāsase gatāsuna gatāsuncha nānu sochanti pandita. Pandita, that those who are learned, they are not affected by this body, either dead or alive. So that means one should be inquisitive to learn about the soul which is sitting in the body. That is real knowledge. So one who is inquisitive about understanding that knowledge, he requires a spiritual master. Not that one who wants to keep this body fit or wants to reduce fat. No. For him there is no necessity of a spiritual master. That he can go to a doctor or a medical physician. That's all he can advise. What is the use of going to a spiritual master? Spiritual master means jignāsu śreya uttamam. Who can teach you about the highest benediction? He is spiritual master. So we shall discuss in next meeting. This is very interesting. And you will be profited if you please come and hear. Any question? Yes?
Prabhupada, these days there are so many men who are claiming to have found the Absolute, who are claiming to be spiritual masters in their own right. How does one tell who is a bona fide spiritual master?
Yeah. What is your idea, a bona fide spiritual master?
One who can teach the Absolute.
So, spiritual master, just like Krishna is spiritual master, and Lord Chaitanya is spiritual master. We are talking about Lord Chaitanya's teaching to Sanatana Goswami. That means Lord Chaitanya is the spiritual master. Similarly, in the Bhagavad Gita, we find Arjuna is taught by Krishna, Bhagavad Gita. So, there is no difficulty to understand who is spiritual master. Is there any difficulty? Because we see that Lord Chaitanya is teaching Sanatana Goswami and Krishna is teaching Arjuna. So, both Lord Chaitanya and Krishna are teaching spiritual master. Is there any difficulty to understand? So, anyone who represents Lord Chaitanya and Krishna, he is spiritual master. That's all. Anyone who speaks exactly what Lord Chaitanya said, exactly what Krishna said, then he is spiritual master. Just like a teacher who says that I have passed MA. Now what is the proof? That means if he speaks exactly like persons who had passed MA examination, then he is MA. A medical practitioner who is approved by other medical practitioners in the medical college, he is medical practitioner. Similarly, if you want to test who is spiritual master, you have to see the standard spiritual master, Krishna and Lord Chaitanya and similar. Even Lord Jesus Christ, there are Lord Buddha, they are also spiritual masters. But they spoke in different circumstances, that is different thing. But if you want to know who is a spiritual master, then you have to test him whether he is speaking exactly like the bona fide spiritual master. See, Narottam Das Thakur has explained about this, who is spiritual master. What is that? He says, Sadhu, Shastra, Guru, Vakya, Tinete, Koriya, Oikya. If you want to advance yourself in spiritual science, then you have to test these three things. What is that? Sadhu, saintly person. Sadhu, Shastra, scriptures. And spiritual master. Now suppose you want to know who is the spiritual master, then you have to test whether he is speaking just like other saintly persons and whether he is following scriptures, sadhu shastra. So, you have to test a spiritual master by corroborating whether he is speaking according to the scriptural injunction, whether he is speaking to other saintly persons. So any in the world, anywhere you go, this standard spiritual master, take it, Lord Jesus Christ, or Buddha, or Shankara, or Ramanujacharya, or Chaitanya, nobody will say that you make adjustment here and live peacefully. Everyone will say that you have to extinguish this material existence. Lord Buddha says Nirvana, and Shankara says Brahma Satya Jagan Mithya, and Krishna says Sarva Dhanman Parityajya Mamekam Saranam Bhaja. Lord Jesus Christ says that you have to go to the kingdom of God, just come with me. So nobody says that let us make a United Nations organization and stick up to thousands of flags and let there be peace and prosperity and let the war go on in any part of the world. That is not spiritual master. Spiritual master means that he is interested with the other world beyond this material. That is spiritual master. Yes. Master means who is master of the science. That's all. You must know everything of spiritual.